Amen and amen. Let's begin to worship God because He is worthy. Let's thank Him because He is worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be honored. He is the King of kings. He is the Lord of lords. He is the God that never changed. He is the God that never disappointed. He is the God that answers prayer. He is the God that makes a way where it seems to be no way. Let's thank Him for the first day, for the first month of, for the month of January. Let's thank Him for the month of February. Let's thank Him for the month of March. Let's thank Him for this month of April. And let's open our mouth and begin to thank Him because He is worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be honored. Let's thank Him for the first day in this month of April. Let's thank Him for today being the second day. Let's thank Him for the grace to see today being the first Saturday in the month of April. It can only be Him. May His name alone be highly praised. Let's just open our mouth and begin to tell Him thank you. You can tell Him thank you in your own dialect. Tell Him thank you. Tell Him thank you. This is the fourth month of the year. Let's tell Him thank you. Let's tell Him thank you. The fourth is the number of balance. Let's tell Him thank you. Let's tell Him thank you. Let's tell Him thank you for preserving your life. Let's appreciate this God. For giving the angels of God charge over your life, over your home, over whatever thing you lay your hands on. Let's appreciate this God. Let's appreciate Him. Let's appreciate Him. He is worthy. He is worthy. He is worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be honored. He is the God of gods. He is the King of kings. He is the Lord of lords. He is the God that never changed. He is the God that never disappointed. He is the God that answers prayer. He is the God that makes a way where it seems to be no way. Father, may your name alone be highly praised. Baba, may your name alone be highly lifted up. Blessed be to your holy name. Hallowed be to your name, for you are so powerful. Be thou magnified. Be thou glorified. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. You are all welcome to Saturday prayer meeting. You are all welcome in Jesus' name. The theme of this month is still our month of prayer, part 3. I am trusting God that there is what God wants to do in the life of His people. My prayer is that as He's doing all these things in the life of His people, you that is hearing my voice, you will not be left behind in the mighty name of Jesus. And the theme is taken from the book of James chapter 5 verse 13a. James chapter 5 verse 13a. Bible said that is anyone among you suffering? Let him pray. Is anyone cheerful? So when you study your Bible, you will understand that it's not only when you are in jubilation that you are to pray. It's even when you are sad. Bible said that you are to pray. My prayer for you is that as we are still in this month of prayer, that the God of all flesh, the God that answers prayer, we take you to a higher level that will make you that you are to pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Because prayer commands favor. Prayer commands favor. Prayer brings speed. When you are a praying man or praying woman, you will see speed as you are to pray. I see speed coming to your way in the mighty name of Job. Because the book of Job chapter 42 verse 10, Job chapter 42 verse 10 says, and the Lord restored Job's losses. All the things that Job lost, Bible is telling us that God restored it when he prayed for his friends. So praying for his friends, so this time God is using this opportunity to take us to the level we should know that we cannot be praying only for ourselves alone. That we can as well pray for our friends. We can as well pray for our loved ones. That one, we call that one intercessory prayers. My prayer for you is that as you started to have time to pray for your loved ones, as you started to pray, to have time to pray for your friends, I see God giving you answers in the mighty name of Jesus. Because Bible said that indeed the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before. This is a story of Job that if you are a Christian, you know the problem of Job. If you study your Bible very well, you see, you notice that Job is not even poor. Job has things. But there's one thing that gives me happy, that marvels me. God knows Job. God knows Job. Because when you study your Bible, the case of Job is like a case of debating But because God knows Job, God now stood and said that, go in Job, and whatever thing you Satan want to do to Job, don't touch those Job's soul. My question now, you as a child of God, you as a Christian hearing my voice, did God know you? Can God tell Satan, go, but don't touch his or her heart? Is the question that you need to answer. Maybe the answer is no. Because there are some of the things that when the thing happened to you, you will just know yourself that you know your level. You don't need to wait for your pastor or for a man of God, a woman of God to tell you your level. You know your level. You know what's your capacity. You know your capacity, what you are up to. My prayer is that as we are still in this season of prayer, God will help you, because today I am seeing mountain of fire, the mountain of fire dropping, falling upon people's life. In the mind, because when this mountain falls upon your life, it will help your life. When enemies want to attack you, God will just warn them, tell them the boundary. Tell them the boundary that they are not even allowed to cross. My prayer for you is that as we are to pray today, I see this mountain falling upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Because the book of Psalm 55 verse 17, Psalm 55 verse 17, Bible said that evening and morning and at noon, I will pray. So you as a Christian, you are to pray in the evening. You are to pray in the morning. You are to pray as well at noon. And cry aloud, and he shall hear my voice. Bible is telling us that as you pray in the evening, in the morning, and at noon, when you open your mouth and speak, that he will hear you. As we are to pray this afternoon, he will hear us in the mighty name of Jesus. Not only that he will hear us, he will answer us in the mighty name of Jesus. Because the book of Daniel chapter 6 verse 10, Daniel chapter 6 verse 10, Bible said that, now, when Daniel knew that the written was signed, he went home. And in his upper room, you as a Christian, do you have upper room? You say you are a Christian. The question is, do you have upper room? Daniel has upper room. Do you have a place that you normally communicate with your maker? That if those that have children, that when you tell your children it's praying time, they know the position that they normally, everybody normally meets. Like today, that is Saturday prayer meeting. You know the time. When the time comes, you leave whatever thing you are doing, you're not joined. My prayer for you is that if you don't have upper room, God will help you. You will begin today to have your own upper room in the mighty name of Jesus, because we are still. Bible is still telling us concerning this man called Daniel. He said that with his windows open toward Jerusalem, he knelt down on his knees. Bible said that three times that day, and he prayed. Bible is telling us three times that day. Three times that day. You as a Christian, how many times do you pray in a day? How many times do you pray in a day? Are you this type of Christian that at night when you want to pray, sleep will just enter? Are you still in this level that is only the time you want to pray that your eye will be closing? My prayer for you is that as we are still in this season of prayer, God will help you. God will deal with that power, that spirit that is making you each time you want to sleep, your eye will be closing in the mighty name of Jesus. Bible said that Daniel knelt down on his knee. He knelt. What I want to ask here is this only kneeling down that you are using? It's not only kneeling down. Daniel kneel down does not mean that you, when you want to pray, you must kneel down. You can sit down and pray. You can stand up and pray. But we have to look for the one that God that suits you. If you are this type that when you are sitting down to pray, your eye will be closing, you change it. You not started to do standing ovation. You stand up and pray. If you are the type that if you even stand up and be quiet and pray, it will not work for you. around your the corners for you started to move. As time goes on, God will be helping you to train you. Everything in life you need to train. You need training. You need to train yourself. As God is helping you, you help yourself as well. When I came to Germany a few years ago, because my background is the background that when you are praying your midnight prayer, you don't stand, you don't do only standing ovation. You walk from one place to another praying. So when I did it, my husband, the first day I did it, when I landed here, my husband told me, here is not Nigeria. Here is not Nigeria. This system, you are disturbing neighbors. It was not easy for me. Because that was the system I grew up with. It was not easy for me. True, it was not easy for me. But I have to do what? I have to update by looking for another position. I now started to change. In fact, you even notice that moment that it's not easy for me, because the system I'm used to is system of when you are doing your midnight prayer, you are going from one place to another, from one corner to another. So imagine you now come to a system that you are not allowed to do it because you are disturbing neighbors at that night. But I don't have any other choice. I started to learn another method. So that's why that it was not easy for me that moment. My husband was even all the time, as I just moved, noise, you are making noise, you are making noise. I said, But as time goes on, as I'm even applying that update, I am praying, Holy Spirit help me. Holy Spirit help me. I need you help me so that I will not be disturbing neighbors, so that neighbors will not call police for me. And to the glory of God, it doesn't take time. I now use another system that I will even be doing my midnight prayer. You will not know that somebody is there. So you need to, if you are this type that when you kneel down like Daniel, you will feel asleep. You can change that position by not kneeling down. You can change that position by not kneeling down. You can look for any other position. Back home, when we are going back home, each time they wake us up to do midnight prayer, sleep, we just close my eyes. My mother will be telling you, go and use a cold water and clean your face. Maybe you go up like that. You have to you look for cold water and wipe your face so that the sleep will be out of your face. In fact, if you didn't do it well, as my mom is even singing and notice that she is not hearing your voice, watch what will happen. It's cold water that she will pour on you. If it's rainy season, you don't have a bit. When it's come at time is dry season in Nigeria, you will hate yourself with that cold water. You will even hate her for that moment. So what am I trying to bring here? You must not kneel down to pray. You can look for another system that is suitable for you. My prayer is that as you are to apply all these techniques, I see God helping you to grow in the mighty name of Jesus. And Bible said that on his knees and three times that day, and he prayed and gave thanks before his God. When you are praying, do you have time to tell God thank you? Do you create time to show God how gratitude you are? How grateful you are? Do you create that time? If you are not this time that nobody create that time, begin today to create it. As you start it today, I see God helping you in the mighty name of Jesus. Our Bible said that as was custom since early days. So, praying of 18 did not start today. It's not me and you that started it. It has been like that since. Because the book of Acts chapter 3 verse 1, Bible said, this one is a story of Peter and John. Bible said that now Peter and John went up together to the temple. The temple can be church. The temple can be that now that we are now in our Saturday prayer meeting, praying. They said that they went to church temple. That temple is a church at the hour of prayer, the ninth hour. My question here is, as you, as a Christian, is it only Saturday prayer meeting that you have time to be on fire? Is it only Saturday prayer meeting that you pray earnestly like Elijah? My prayer is that if it's only this Saturday or when you are in the church that you pray very well, God will help you, because it's not normal. It's not normal. You're supposed to be praying whether it's Saturday prayer meeting or not Saturday prayer meeting. You're supposed to be praying. Bible said it meant how to pray. My prayer for you is that God will help you. This month is a month of April. God will help you. You will balance in all these areas. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because the book of Acts of Apostles chapter 10 verse 9. Acts chapter 10 verse 9. Bible said that the next day, as they went on their journey and drew near the city, Peter went up on the housetop to pray about the sixth hour. My prayer for you is that God will help you. Holy Spirit will assist you. That starting from now, you will not be praying only even six times, three times in a day. God will help you to expand you in the mighty name of God, because the fire of God that is going to that mountain of prayer that is going to fall upon your life, you will be praying. Whether you are even in the toilet or you're taking your bath, you will be praying. Bible says that men ought to pray. My prayer is that as this mountain is falling upon your life today, I see God giving you answers in the mighty name of Jesus. I see Him giving you answers in the mighty name of Jesus. As we are to worship God this hour, as we are to worship our Maker this hour, I see this mantle will fall upon His people. This mantle of prayer, it will fall upon His people today in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I said the fountain of life is flowing everywhere. Whosoever drink shall never ever thirst again. The fountain of life is flowing everywhere. Whosoever drink shall never ever thirst again. Because as the fountain of life is flowing in today's Saturday prayer meeting, this fountain of life, you will never be tested again in the mighty name of Jesus. You will never be tested again in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we give you thanks, we give you praise. What a mighty God we serve. Blessed be to your holy name. Hallowed be to your name, for you are so powerful, you are so glorious. Be thou magnified, be thou exalted. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. Father, have your way. Adonai heaven, take fully charge, take fully control. Be thou exalted, be thou magnified. Oh Lord, I put you in front of my melody. You are all that matters. You are all that matters. You are my Jesus. You are all that matters. You are all that matters. Away. You are all that matters. Away. tell him that he is beautiful. Tell him that he is beautiful. He is beautiful. Tell him he is beautiful. He is beautiful. He is mighty. 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 He is mighty God. He is mighty God. He is mighty. He is mighty in the mighty name of Jesus. He is mighty. He is mighty. He is mighty in the marvelous name of Jesus. In the glorious name of Jesus. In the marvelous name of Jesus. Blessed be to you. Now tell him as he's going around doing good today, Saturday prayer meeting. Tell him not to pass you by. Tell him not to pass you by, because the mountain of prayer is going to fall upon his people in today's Saturday prayer meeting. Tell him that you don't want to miss that mountain. Tell him that that mountain of prayer, that you are not going to miss that mountain in the mighty name of Jesus, in the powerful name of Jesus. Blessed be to your holy name. Hallowed be to your name, for you are so powerful. Be thou glorified. Be thou magnified. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Because the book of Job chapter 1 verse 19. Job chapter 1 verse 19. Bible said that, and suddenly a great wind came from across the wilderness and struck the four corners of the house. And it fell on the young people, and they are dead. And I alone have escaped to tell you. Amen. We are going to take our prayer. This is the fourth month. We are going to pray. Father, every evil wind from the four cardinal points, east, west, north, and south, against my life, against my household, we are going to command them to catch fire. Because when they catch fire, you will now decree. We are going to take two prayer points from this Bible passage this hour. So the first prayer point we are going to take from this Bible passage right now is that every evil wind from the four cardinal points, from the east, west, north, and south, against my life, against my household, catch fire in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and fire prayer. My Father, my Father, my Father, my Father, every evil wind from the four cardinal points, from the east, from the west, from the north, from the south, against my life, against my household, catch fire in the name of Jesus. 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 Blessed be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The same that evil wind, we are still going to pray. As that evil wind, every evil wind that will be coming from the four corners of the earth, Father, I will escape. Father, I will escape. Amen. So we are going to pray. Father, every evil wind from the four cardinal points, from the four corners of the earth, against my life, against my household, Father, we will escape. Open your mouth and fire prayer. My Father, my Maker, every evil wind from the four cardinal points, from the four corners of the earth, against my life, against my household, my Father, my Maker, I will escape in the name of Jesus. We 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 will escape in the name of Jesus. Blessed be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. We will escape in the mighty name of Jesus. We will escape in the mighty name of Jesus. As I have declared, so shall we be. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit. We are going to take another prayer from this Bible passage. We are going to pray, Father, every evil wind from the four cardinal points, by the power in the Holy Ghost, I command them, stop in the name of Jesus. You need to stand and command it, stop. Because Bible said that God has given all the power to cast and to bless, to curse and to bless, to bind and to loose. So now we are going to command that evil wind to stop. It will stop physically, it will stop spiritually. Now we are going to take the prayer. Father, every evil wind from these four God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father in heaven. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Every evil wind from the four cardinal points, in any way they are going to make your ugly hair against your life, against your home, by the power and the Holy Ghost, I command that evil wind, stop right now in the name of Jesus. 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 As I have commanded, so shall it be. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' mighty name, I have command. We are going to pray. You are going to say, Father, release the angels to go forth to the four corners of my home. This is the fourth month of the year. So we are going to pray, Father, release the angels to go forth to the four corners of my home. My home. Open your mouth and fire prayer. My Father, my Maker. My Father, my Maker. Release the angels to go forth to the four corners of my home in the name of Jesus. My Father, my Father. Release the angels to go forth to the four corners of my home. Release the angels to go forth to the four corners of my home in the name of Jesus. To the four corners of my home in the name of Jesus. To the four corners of my home in the name of Jesus. Blessed be to your holy name. Hallowed be to your name, for you are so powerful, you are so glorious. Be thou glorified, be thou magnified. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. As we are praying right now, I see the God of all flesh releasing angels to go forth to the four corners of your home. In the mighty name of Jesus. As I'm to shout power right now, four times. Those ones that their own have already taken place, you will begin now to confirm it. By the power of the Holy Ghost, at the count of what? Power! Yes, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus. Power! In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus. Power! Yes, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 This last one, I'm going to shout power. Hey, God is going to confirm it in another dimension, in another level, in another way. Because when you listen to me, when we started this today, Saturday prayer meeting, I told you that I see God. I see God. I see the mantle of prayer falling upon His people in today's Saturday prayer meeting. As I'm to drop this power, this last one, I see the God of all flesh moving in another dimension. By the power of the Holy Ghost, power! Yes, Lord. 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 Blessed be to your holy name. Hallowed be to your name, for you are so powerful. Be thou glorified. Be thou magnified. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. We are going to pray. We are going to pray. You are going to decree upon your life that in your life, Father, complete and fulfill all the things God started, all the things that you God started in my life. Father, I decree completion and fulfillment of all the things you God have started in my life. Open your mouth and declare that upon your life in the name of Jesus. My Father, my Maker, I decree completion and fulfillment of all the things that God has fathered in my life. Father, in this month of April, I receive anointing for completion. I receive anointing for fulfillment. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the powerful name of Jesus. In the miraculous name of Jesus. Blessed be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I see God of all flesh completing and fulfilling all the things that He has started in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, blessed be to your holy name. We are going to pray. You are going to decree that only the counsel of God for for your life and your family will manifest. Father, I decree that only the counsel of God for my life and my family will manifest. Open your mouth and declare that in the name of Jesus. My Father, my Maker, I decree upon my life that only the counsel of God for my family, for my life, will manifest in the name of Jesus. Only the counsel of God for my life, for my family, will manifest in the name of Jesus. As I have declared, so shall it be. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit, blessed be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have decreed. Now we are going to decree. We are going to pray and decree upon your life. Sound health and longevity. Sound health and longevity. Sound health and longevity. Open your mouth and declare that upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father, my Maker, I decree upon my life sound health and longevity now and always. 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 Blessed be to your holy name. Hallowed be to your name, for you are so powerful. Be thou glorified, be thou magnified. In Jesus' excellent name, we have prayed. My Father, my Maker, I decree upon the life of your children, your people, sound health and longevity in the mighty name of Jesus. Sound health and longevity now and always in the name of Jesus. As I have declared, so shall it be in your life. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit. Let's just thank him for the answer to our prayers. Thank him for our he answers prayers. Thank him, thank him, thank him, thank you. Father, we thank you. Abba, Father, we thank you. Blessed be to your holy name. Thank you, Father, for everything. It can only be you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks. Maybe you are sick in your body. You know yourself. Maybe you are having pains. You know that place that is hurting you. Place your left hand on that position and stretch forth your right hand toward the devices you are watching me from. I am trusting God this afternoon that the healer will move in a mighty way, and he will touch you, and he will make you whole. In the mighty name of Jesus. The right hand of God is powerful. As I stretch forth my right hand right now towards your direction, Father, let the healing power of God flow. In the mighty name of God, let the healing power of God flow. In the mighty name, every sick in the house, I speak into your life. Be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. Be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. Be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. You are healed in the mighty name of Jesus. As I have decreed, and so shall it be in your life. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit, blessed be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have decreed, I have prayed. Check yourself and don't fail to send us testimony. You know the area that God has taught you. Don't send testimony to us. We want to hear from you. We want to know what God has done in your life. As you do so, God will bless your name. God will bless you. The testimony will be permanent in the mighty name of Jesus, because your testimony is very important in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't forget that the healing, when God healed you, you are the one that will enjoy the health. But the testimony, you need to give testimony to the people of God. Amen. As you do so, I see God giving you more answers to your prayers. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Maybe you are this type that you are checking yourself. Each time you heard me when I was preaching, when I was throwing a little weight on the team that's called prayer per three. Maybe you are this type that when you want to pray at night, at night, this problem is only at night. Sleep will cover your face. Sleep will be your problem. Even in the daytime when you want to pray, you'll be having distraction. One thing or the other will take you out of God's presence. I am I'm going to pray right now. Starting from now, begin to observe yourself. That thing, you shall see it no more. In the mighty name of Jesus. That power, that spirit that is involved, you shall see them no more. In the mighty, because as the mountain of God, the mountain of prayer is to fall upon your life right now. Hey, that spirit, that evil spirit, that evil power that is depriving you from not being enjoying the presence of God. Starting from today, you shall see it no more. In the mighty name of Jesus. And maybe you don't have problem, but your own is that you want to enter into that realm that you'll be seeing yourself that the fire of God in your life is unquenchable. As I'm to minister right now, that the same mountain of prayer will fall upon your life. Because as the mountain of prayer is falling upon your life, you will not be growing. You will see yourself operating into this realm of unquenchable fire. At the count of four, power! Yes, Lord, take it. In the mighty name of Jesus. The mantle of prayer is falling right now. The mantle of prayer is falling right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Take! In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Take! In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Take! In the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus. Yes, Lord. In the marvelous name of Jesus. In the glorious name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. There is somebody, you are watching me. There is what God is going to do in your life. That testimony will even shake you. When you look at what God did to you, you'll just be looking at the testimony as if to say that, God, this testimony is even too much. This testimony is even too much. I say somebody, there is what God is said to do for you. Not next year, this year, 2022. You, in fact, my people used to use this word, said, honor Jehovah Vunitoko. Which means that because your mouth is filled with laughter, if you want to blow firewood like Africa normally use, if you don't have hand fan, because your mouth is filled with laughter, is filled with smile, you cannot even blow air for the fire to catch light. If you are that person that have this testimony, that have this prophecy, as I'm to shout power right now, God is going to confirm it to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Power! Yes, Lord. Father, I need evidence and confirmation by the power and the Holy Ghost. Yes, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. There is somebody, you are watching me. There is what God is going to do for you that will make you to sing this song. As that thing happened, you will not even know the time that you started singing this song. You start to bow down for your maker. The honor of this message, God will confirm it to you right now. By the power and the Holy Ghost. Father, I need evidence and confirmation. Confirm the honor of this message right now. By the power and the Holy Ghost. Power! Yes, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 There is somebody, you are watching me. God is telling me to tell you that what he said to do for you this year, 2022, we make you to sing this song. Biano solom kene chineke no mere muma. Biano solom kene chineke no mere muma. Biano solom kene chineke no mere muma. Biano solom kene chineke no. Father, I need evidence and confirmation. By the power and the Holy Ghost, the owner of this message, receive it. And they come to authority. Yes, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Blessed Redeemer, we give you thanks. Mighty man of war, we thank you. There is somebody, you are watching me. There is what God wants to do for you. This message I'm giving you now. Watch yourself from now. It's no longer for, because the testimony is already at your door. I see somebody in the realm dancing. This song. Alpha and Omega, Jehovah Shammah, Alpha and Omega, Jesus na his name. No be say I dey praise, na praise I dey praise. Oh, no be say I dey praise, na praise I dey praise. No be say I dey praise, oh, na my Father I dey praise. Oh, no be say I dey praise, na God I dey praise. Oh, no be say I dey praise, oh, na my Father I dey praise. Oh, no be say I dey praise, na God I dey praise. Oh, you are watching me. This song is for you. How will you know that you are the one? This one I'm even talking now. The testimony is already at your door. It's already at your door. When that thing happened to you, you will not even know. You will just be singing praises. You will just be dancing. Today said that somebody by your side will ask you, what is happening? You will not begin to tell the person that you are not crazy, that you are just praising God. How will you know that you are the person? God is going to confirm whoever that have this message right now by the power of the Holy Ghost. Yes, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the powerful name of Jesus. In the glorious name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Adonai, heaven, we thank you. Mighty man of war, we thank you. This month is a month of April. April is the fourth month of the year. Number four is a number of balance. I don't know the areas you are tossing God for balance, both spiritually and physically. I see balance coming to that areas right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. I don't know that area. You have been praying. You are looking for you every time. Your eyes is on that area because you want to hear balance. God said that I should tell you good news in the mighty name of God, because I see balance entering those areas in the mighty name of Jesus. So, by the power of the Holy Father, confirm it. Take in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm waiting for balance. Let it fall upon your life. Power in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm wanting for balance. Because when this anointing fall upon your life, hey, both spiritually and physically, you will balance. Both spiritually and physically, you will balance. All these areas, it will penetrate by the power of the Holy Ghost. Take it in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the marvelous name of Jesus. In the powerful name of Jesus. Hey, because this is our month, or the fourth month of the year, and the four is the number of balance. I declare upon your life, may the God of heaven give you reason to be happy this month. In the mighty name of Jesus. This month, your glory will manifest. In the mighty name of Jesus. This month, you will know no sorrow. No sorrow. No sorrow will near you. In the mighty name of Jesus. This month, no enemy shall take you out of God's place. In the mighty name of Jesus. I declare upon your life that the rest of God's blessing shall pour out on your life this month. In the mighty name of Jesus. You shall fulfill your purpose on the earth. In the mighty name of Jesus. As I have declared, so shall it be your life. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit, let's give him thanks. Thank him for everything. Thank him for his wording. Thank him for his wording. Thank him for his faithful. Thank him for not leaving you. Thank him, thank him, thank him. Let's thank him. Let's thank him. Let's thank him. Father, we thank you. Blessed Redeemer, we thank you. What a mighty God we serve.